Man, tell people your name, by the way.
Yeah, my name is Darius Fant, originally from Mississippi. Jermaine and I hail from the same small town, small, humble beginnings. And I'm a drummer now and a teacher in the Nashville area. So that's me.
It's cool to have you in the lab finally.
I know, right? This is fresh. This is. I like the setup, bro. I'm proud of you.
Man, I'm
if
still
I'm working you enough, man. This is dope, dude. So thank you for bringing me in, dog.
Man, my pleasure, dude. I'm a little home studio, small beginnings, but you know, it gets the job done.
Oh yeah.
Done some countless records here, and so it works for me.
Oh yeah.
You know, so I ain't complaining, but you know, I'm a beginners, man. Dude, how you like Nashville?
Man, I love it. It's new,
okay,
of course, and some adjustments have to happen. But man, praying God's will and everything He has for me, man. I'm ready to jump in the deep end of the pool and get after it. So
cool, man. You've made a lot of musical contacts over there.
Yeah, some pretty substantial ones so far, man. And just hopefully to make more as time kind of goes on, most definitely.
Cool, man. I know for me, it took a minute. I mean, I started meeting people when I first moved to Atlanta and kind of, I guess, getting introduced to the scene, that kind of thing. But the toughest part was just kind of really learning the scene. And I think for me, it was definitely a culture shock when I moved to Atlanta. Coming from Mississippi, the music scene, so to speak, wasn't as jumping as it is, if I can say that way. As it is down here in Atlanta, from the area we came from, Northeast Mississippi, like it's came up a lot more now, and a lot more people are doing a lot more things musically. But it wasn't nothing compared to moving down here, and it's like everybody down here is on it. And so I felt like I had, for the first 2 or 3 years, I felt like I literally had to play catch up to just keep up with everybody.
I understand.
And so I don't know if your experience is similar there.
Yeah. As it with anybody in a new location, man, you're not gonna jump right in and immediately get after it. And I guess I say that analogy, you're not gonna jump right in the deep end of the pool and swim right away.
Right.
But man, gradually start at that 3 foot in. And
don't jump in 8 foot if you can't swim.
go launch out into the deep, man. Most definitely. I gotta wear the little floaties right now.
Exactly. But I mean, it's funny that you say it, and sometimes I think it can be cool to actually do the opposite, actually jump into 8 foot.
Yeah.
Because sometimes when you jump into 8 foot, you will find out you actually can swim. Okay. And sometimes because of fear, we won't launch out into the deep. We'll kind of, you know what I'm saying? It's like we'll jump out there into that 3 foot part and just kind of wait a little while. Yeah. If you ain't careful, you'll wait too long.
Yeah.
If you just jump off the diving board and jump in there, it's like it's sink or swim at that point.
Yeah.
And so it puts a fire up under you and makes you kind of, what would normally take you 2 to 3 years, you kind of end up doing it in 5 to 6 months, because it's like, you know what I got to lose at this point.
Right.
And so I think by my second year, that's kind of the mindset I started developing. It's like, you know what do I have to lose? Especially after being a struggling musician with nothing, that kind of thing. Right. It's like, you at some point, it's like, okay, I got to do this.
Yeah.
It's either now or never.
Yeah.
Or you're not gonna eat.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
and you gotta eat.
Yeah, you gotta eat. You definitely gotta eat. Let's play with that concept we were coming up with earlier. You know, we was playing around with this loop here. I think I was doing E flat. Thank you.
Thank you.